a humorous note that marriage is all about shouting, "What'd you say?" from one room to the next. But as you get older, sometimes that "what'd you say?" is when you're sitting right next to each other. And it's not just reserved, though, for people as they get older. Hearing loss can affect anyone at any age. And here to kind of just give us an update on a few things going on, not only with the hearing community, Nola Aronson from Advanced Audiology, but we're also going to talk about some contributions she has made to some local organizations here. Well, welcome back to the Hometown Morning Show, Nola.
Thank you, George. I appreciate it.
And talking about this, I was asking really quickly off the air about some of the things you see on TV. Because, you know, hearing aids are such a, in some cases, and I know that we've talked about this before, that people think it's like a detriment to their look, although so many of them now are practically invisible. You can barely see them. But they've got like the miracle ear, or Lee Majors a few years ago, you know, $6 million man hawking the bionic ear as like a, some sort of replacement for actually taking a test from a certified person who actually can really truly assess your hearing. As, you know, these are situations that each hearing potential hearing loss is different from one person to the next, that there's kind of a one size fits all thing. What is that a good way to go with just like one of these miracle ears, or should someone actually get tested?
Well, actually, miracle ear is a brand name,
right?
And it's made by a major hearing aid manufacturer. So miracle ear has the name that, you know, makes you feel like a hearing aid is a miracle ear. But it's really only a brand name, and it happens to be a nice, you know, company. And but it's a one, you know, shop, you know, that those circuits that they have in Miracle Ear, if that circuit doesn't work for you, then you have no other choice. So it's like a private label.
Right. Okay.
So at Advanced Audiology, there are 10 major manufacturers left, and we carry 4 of them. You can't learn all the software for all of them. But an audiologist is somebody that has to go to school now, nowadays, for 4 years to get your doctorate. So it's not like anybody can test your hearing. I mean, you can get a hearing screening, but that's only in relation to sell you a hearing aid. It's not in relation to make a diagnosis.
Right.
So we are the only people that can make diagnoses. Now, in the industry, in the world today, they're saying that hearing aids are so expensive. But people don't realize that we bundle our prices. So when you get a hearing aid, it's not only the price of the hearing aid, but it includes service. Hearing aids need a lot of service. You need to get them cleaned. You need to get them adjusted from time to time. They last a very long time, so you want to keep them up. So what people don't realize is, yes, you'll find hearing aids less expensive online because you're only finding a hearing aid. You're not finding the person to fit it. You're not finding any service with it. So what they're saying to us now is that we should, because of the big box stores, and now there's Senator Elizabeth Warren is trying to put forth a over-the-counter hearing aid like reading glasses, and that anybody could just go in and buy it. You don't even have to know what your hearing loss is. It's not going to be FDA approved, but you can just go buy it like reading glasses. I don't know if that's going to be really a detriment to everybody, because there is another hearing aid company through an insurance company that you send in your audiogram, and then they mail you a hearing aid. Hearing aids have to be fit correctly in the ear. If you think the hearing aid's too tinny, how are you going to get that changed if there's nowhere for you to get that changed? If you think it's too loud, you know, it's just ridiculous. So,
And there are different forms of hearing loss with different frequencies and things that some people have the issues with more of the lower range. Some people have the issues with the higher range. And it's very important to have someone that actually knows how to diagnose that. And you're right about having it fitted properly, because that could be either really uncomfortable, or it's not going to do any good for you anyway.
Right. And then you're going to complain. Like this, everybody says, don't work. My friend doesn't wear their hearing aids. They spent all this money and they don't wear their hearing aids. Well, that's because they didn't go to the right person, the person that follows them along and takes care of them the whole time. So the problem that I'm having after 40 years of doing this profession is to unbundle my prices, because there's these third-party companies now that are buying through the manufacturer, offering lower prices to the insurance companies, like, you know, workman's comp, and then we're still doing the same job we were doing, but we're getting paid very little. So now I'm going to have to nickel and dime people when they come in. I'm going to have to charge for the batteries. I'm going to have to charge if you want your hearing aid cleaned. I'm going to have to charge for every adjustment. Every time you walk in my door, it's $65. That's ridiculous. People will not walk in the door then, because they'll go, I don't want to spend the money. So now they really won't wear their hearing aids. So that's my philosophy. I'm so used to giving my services away and making it so that people are successful with their hearing, so they can lead a better social life. It's really hard for me to change my ways. And
you offer free screenings, right?
Yes, we offer free screenings.
You know, even if you think you have the best hearing in the world, check it out. Or if your kids listen to the iPods super, super loud, you might want to just double check and make sure there's not anything in the future.
Right.
Speaking of kids, you do a lot of contributions to local organizations out here, such as like the Boys and Girls Club. Can you tell me a little bit about that? What got you involved?
Yeah. So I believe that I like to give back to my community. This Santa Clarita is the most wonderful community, and we have over 100 nonprofit organizations in this community. So I have decided that part of my philosophy with my business is taking 10% of the proceeds of my hearing aid sales and donating it back to a different nonprofit every month. This year, I'm celebrating my 30th anniversary in Santa Clarita, and I started this about a year ago. And it makes not only me feel really good that I'm helping out, but it makes the patient feel good. When you buy a hearing aid through me, 10% of that, you're donating back to your community. So I have decided to, this month, support the Boys and Girls Club, because I love children. I started off as a teacher. I was a special ed teacher for many years before I was an audiologist. And so I believe that books make people smarter. And when you know how to read, you can find out all kinds of things and you can really grow. So I was able to obtain fiction books by an author called L. Ron Hubbard. And I got audiobooks and regular books, and I went over to the Boys and Girls Club, and all the kids got a book. And they were all excited because they're adventure stories and they're science fiction stories. And they were so excited that they got to take home a brand new book. And then I told them that they have to share it with their friends. And there's a lesson plan that goes with it that somebody can do with them. And this, you know, having these great stories will encourage kids, I hope, to read. So I'm really into helping literacy in the United States, because the average reading level of a person in the United States is third grade.
Wow.
And, you know, it's very hard to get anywhere if that's all you could read is up to third grade level.
Well, we appreciate your contributions. Now, the Boys and Girls Club, I know you've also been active with the SCV Senior Center as well, so we really, really appreciate that. Advanced Audiology, what's the best way to contact you for either information or if you want to set up a free screening?
Yeah, so this year, because it's our 30th anniversary, last year we gave 1,000 free hearing screenings. This year we want to give 1,500. So all you have to do is call 661-253-EARS. That's 661-253-3277. We are located on Valencia Boulevard, right next to AAA in the Owen Patterson Troop Building, where the ones with the purple sign.
Right.
And not to get us confused.
Outstanding. Very easy to get to from anywhere in the valley. Nola Aronson, always having a pleasure having you on the show. I think it's terrific. And keep up the great work. And I know you're taking a trip, so good luck with that. And we'll see you back in a couple months.
Okay. Thank you, George.
You bet.